Ooh, all right, everybody, welcome back to Zelda Bomb Squad. As always, I am your man, Crazy Juan. We got another good one for you today. We are playing Harvest Moon 64 and continuing on with The Legend of Frost, How I Became Me, Baby. And away we go. Now, obviously, as previously established, today is the day I enter Bojack into his second annual horse race. And this time, it's going to go a little bit differently than it did last time, let me tell you. But we're getting ahead of ourselves. Just a smidge. So, it seems my baby doll done dropped the egg, cause... Wait. This would be sweet. Why? Cause I'm tired? I've never wanted to eat cake like this before. I feel so languid. I don't feel like doing anything. Oh. My wife is... There's something wrong with my wife. There we go. I don't know what languid means, baby. I feel like something sweet. Why? Because I'm tired? I've never wanted to eat cake like this before. Well, if my baby wants a piece of cake, my baby gets a piece of cake. So I'm gonna go to the bakery later and go get a piece of cake for her. Yes, I do. My flowers are growing. Ooh, excuse me.
Hey, why don't you enter the local horse race tomorrow? I think you do pretty good.
Yeah, I damn sure will do pretty good.
Good. I'll help get the horse ready in the morning.
Yeah, you better.
Well, goodbye. See you later.
Yeah, Chief. Yeah, I showed him something or another. I don't know. Yeah, you know what would be really sweet right now? Like a mass fucking harvest of like everything, but I know it's not going to happen. I will settle for, at least the tomatoes and the eggplants. Yes. More specifically, the tomatoes if I can't get the eggplants. But let's find out how happy I'm going to be. Sploosh! I got exactly what I wanted. Hell yes, I love when that happens. Ooh, and I have all my spaces too, so it's gonna be a lot quicker to do. Oh, man. I'm just rhyming left and right now, dude. I'm loving this shit. I'm feeling the vibes. So, what led to my felony? So, one day, you know, I get home from work, and my roommate is not yet home from work. And, you know, he usually works late hours, because his father owned a specific type of company. And I'm not going to say what it was, because I don't want to incriminate him in any way, or I don't want to like obviously I, you know, besides, because I've already made statements about this stuff on Facebook already, so I've already done that, so you know, I just and obviously not everybody know who I was talking about, but you know, I don't want the world to know exactly who this person is, and you know, just whatever. So his dad owned a specific type of company which needed trucks. So, you needed a specific type of trucks. I'm not going to say what kind of trucks, but you needed certain type of trucks to do certain type of jobs. And, it wasn't the nicest smelling stuff either. It wasn't shit, but it wasn't the nicest of smelling things. I'll leave it at that. And, his dad wanted to retire because his dad, you know, was running the company for years and years and years. And his son's been, you know, pretty much taking over the reins. But, you know, not having, you know, the efficient team needed to comfortably step down and say, hey, the company's yours, I'm just going to own it, you run it, and you do you, make me proud. So, apparently, his dad had a talk with him one day and was like, hey, listen, you know, because we had, you know, a few people that we worked with in the nightclub industry worked for him and his dad. And, you know, one of them was still there. The other one was just like, dude, I can't take your dad's fucking tyranny anymore. I'm done. Like, your dad is an asshole. And apparently, like, he stopped working there because that guy was also the person that I took the head of security job from. So he worked with them too. But he eventually got to a point where he couldn't take his, you know, his dad's bullshit. And believe me, that definitely becomes a thing much, much later on. And trust me, it's not good to hear. It's really not. Like this guy is not, I guarantee, this guy's not going to look that great once the story's over. Or once his segment of the story is over, he's not going to be looking the greatest. I can guarantee that right now. But that's beside the point. He doesn't know if he's ready, if he's comfortable with the team that they currently have to run everything efficiently without him, because he doesn't want to be in the field anymore. He's done. He's had enough. So, did I miss a tomato somewhere? No? What the fuck? That was weird. What? I don't know. I seem to... I don't know. Whatever. Like, I... Oh, okay, I know why. I know why. Never mind. I'm dumb. Nah, don't mind me. Anyway, he didn't know if he was comfortable enough stepping aside and letting, you know, he had faith in his son, don't get me wrong, but he didn't have faith in the team that was there. And at that point, there was only, like, two other guys there. So, you know, he was actually thinking about selling the company outright. And, so that got him a little nervous, because if he sells the company, he might be out of a job. You know, because whoever buys the company, yeah, they might keep it going, but what if they decide to, you know, sell it or dismantle it or whatever? He might be out of a job, so that scared him. That put him in a place, which is weird, because he was always Mr. Dudley Do-Right, Mr. Can't Do No Wrong, Mr. I Know Everything, and I will explain it to you until you know I know what I know better than you. Yeah, he's kind of one of those guys. But, he always seemed to at least have his shit together, even under the most immense amount of pressure. So, but keep in mind, while I was working at, the government security place while living with this guy, I was able to pay my rent. I need to make that part apparent right now, so you can see I'm still on top of my shit at this point while I'm on my own, no longer living with my parents. At this point, I'm still on top of my game. I'm paying my rent. I'm paying my bills. I'm doing everything I have to do to make myself a success, and I am pulling it off wonderfully. Just know that at this point in time, that's how everything's going. Smoothly, splendidly, phenomenally, and fantastic. So, moving on. He comes home, and he is nervous. He looks like he's about ready to shit himself, level of nervous. And me, not used to seeing him like that, was a little... Oh, whoops, I forgot to do this. I'm so terribly sorry. Like, I'm more than a little nervous. It's like, I've never seen him like this before. Like, what the hell is going on? And he tells me about it. And he tells about the conversation he had with his dad. And he's like, well, you know, what... Oh, I can't believe I forgot to put those away. God, I suck. So... When is that milk gonna go up there, Bob? Do I gotta impregnate your ass again? Cause I will with that seed, baby. And there we go. Actually, I'm thinking of getting 4 cows and 4 sheep, just for the fuck of it. Like, I'm gonna have money. Money's not an issue. I really don't care. I kinda want, you know... I know what I'm doing. Yep, I'm gonna get one more cow, and that's gonna be it. Alright, here you go. Here you go. Okay, so the conversation, and, you know, the conversation that we had, you know, because I'm like, dude, what is the matter with you? And he's like, oh, well, you know, my dad might sell the company, and da-da-da-da. And he's like, because, you know, obviously this guy's not pulling his weight, and he's really throwing him under the bus hard by saying, you know, he's not pulling his weight, you know, he's sleeping on the way to the jobs. You know, he doesn't always look the greatest. You know, his sweatpants always have holes in them. And he doesn't make the company look good. And this and that and this and that and this and that and everything else. Which is why his dad's not 100% comfortable handing over the company to his son so he can retire, you know, and relax at home for the rest of his life. Which he'd easily be able to do. So, you know, when I got promoted to head of security, this guy was like a huge time advocate for me. Like... He was always the one saying, you know, hey, dude, you know, if there's anybody I'd rather take orders from, like, it would be you. Because you know what you're talking about, you know what you want, you know what you're doing, you're passionate about this business and all that, and you have a bright future in it. I can already see it. So, yeah, if there's somebody I want to take orders from, it's going to be you. So it was like, oh my God, dude, I greatly appreciate that. And that's kind of what helped me, give me that kick in the ass to get myself to where I needed to be in order to become head of security, you know, like I was and like I did. And it was all thanks to him for the majority of it. The rest of it was Cosmos showing up drunk at work and another manager being a dick and the general manager not doing shit about it. But I still owed him that bit of gratitude for that because, it, you know, I was super appreciative of it. So, let's keep that. And let's
get this flower too. Oh God, and this thing right here. So you'd stick this in the dog's food bowl. And now we gotta go fishing. Oh shit.
Oh, here's the mailman. I needed to see you. When someone's waiting for a letter, they look so happy when I hand it to them. I get to share their happiness, which makes me feel happy too. Derp, derp, derp. That's great, dude. Here, have a flower, homeboy. Douche. But thank you very much. Because now we gotta be nice to Papyri's dad again, because we really want that power berry, baby. Yeah, we do. Speaking of, where is he at? Things have changed. I'm married now that you're back. You did not know that about me, and you have not seemed to care enough to ask, you son of a bitch. You in here? Yeah, you are. As you travel all over the life and blah, 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 blah. I don't care. Shut up. Take this flower. Eat it. Let's both try our best. Alright, let's go fishing and try to get that power berry, baby. Alright, so, oh my God, did I just not talk about anything, like, this whole episode? Of course you did. It's just not about what you wanted to talk about. Oh, man. I mean, you still have time. So, like, this guy's, what, the felony thing now. Because that's what I was supposed to be talking about. I kind of went off on my own little thing. So, yeah. Oh, no, that's what I was getting at. But he's just like, okay, so, yeah, I'm just really baked, guys. I'm sorry. And he's like, I don't know what I'm going to do. I've been doing this job for, like, 18 years. And, like, I don't know what else I'm going to do if my dad sells a company. I might be out of a job and da-da-da-da. And he looks legitimately frazzled. And I'm like, okay, dude, like, let's just say, for the sake of argument, I decide to be for you what you did, do for you what you did for me. What if I were to put in my 2 weeks notice at my current job, the government security place, which is fantastic and a very super easy fucking job to do with amazing benefits. Like, if I were to leave that job properly, you know, like, how much would I be making full-time for you? And he told me. And, you know, he told me that there were some jobs where you'd be making a shitload. Like, I'm talking, like, $60, $70 an hour. And it was like, oh, as soon as I heard that, like, I was totally on board with it. And, oh, it's you. See ya. Oh, wow, well, fuck you, bro. You want this fish? No? Okay, great. Fuck you, bro. Don't go home too drunk. I'm not gonna, so here you go. Oh my God, I have $30,000. Hell yes. Don't forget about it. I'm not going to. Here, have a flower. Don't forget about Ellie, because I know you want her. I can't get drunk with the good feelings on such a night. Oh, good feelings, huh? Feelings like you kind of like somebody? Is that where this is going, buddy? I think it is. So, like, let me get a book on how to get, like, my CDL book, how to get my CDL license, and, like, give me a few weeks, give me a month or something like that, and, gave me a month. I was reading on how to do this, and, you know, it was just like, okay, great, like, I need to, you know, talk to his dad to make sure, like, the job's mine if I want it. And I did not get a cake from my wife. Oh my God, I am such a fucking dick. But I have her favorite food, which is strawberries, so I'm not a dick this time. Ha ha. Ah. Here you go, sweetness. And the dog. See, we're all here to make you happy.
Jay, my partner.
All right, fine, I will. So, you know, I told him, you know, once I talk to your dad and everything gets cemented, like, I'll put in my 2 weeks. So I did. And that's exactly how it happened. I talked to his dad. And, you know, I didn't want to tell my supervisor at work until everything was set in stone. But this, you know, supervisor's, you know, ass boil found out about it. And he went and told everybody. So my supervisor walked up to me one day and was just like, oh, so I heard you're leaving. Thanks for telling us. And I'm like, who fucking told you? And he said, who? And I'm like, that son of a bitch. Like, I'm like, I'm going to let him have it one day. And, I told everybody, I'm like, that's it. I'm going to let him have it before I leave. And everyone's like, good. He deserves it. He truly deserves it. Better than, more than anybody. He really, really deserves to give it, like, to have it just given to him. So very bad. So, like, well, I'm going to be the one to do it. And that's exactly what's going to happen. So, and that's exactly what I did. I feel so languid. I don't feel like doing anything. I was like, ah. I know that word means, but I feel it. It sucks. And I feel so but that means I'll go back to Thailand. So yeah, it was just like everybody's like, yeah, dude, do it on your way out. Oh, it's gonna be great. Yeah, John, you're gonna be a legend. And then one person gave me a really horrible idea and he goes, yeah, you know what you should do? And I said, what? He goes, you should record it and then play it for all of us. And I'm like, good idea. When in actuality it totally wasn't. It was actually a horrible idea, which actually was a felony that I didn't even know about. So that's kind of what happened. And how did that go? Well, we'll find out in the next episode. We'll go just another minute or two. So I chewed him out and I recorded it. And in the record, and, like, you can actually hear him being like, dude, I don't understand, like, why you're mad at me, but, like, I'm really sorry, but, like, I don't understand, I really wish you wouldn't be so mad at me. And it was, like, really funny to listen to. So, obviously, I played it for the people that wanted to hear it. And, I'll tell you how that ended out, but I'll tell you, you can probably already figure out where that's going. But, yeah. I'll confirm that in the next episode. So everybody, thank you for joining me. Don't forget to join the Bomb Squad. Like, share, and subscribe. Don't forget to leave me a comment below. Let me know how I'm doing. And I will talk to you all in the next episode where we will do the horse race. How is BoJack going to fare this time? Only time can tell. Will I get that sustaining carrot? Will it do anything? Will I get some medals? That's a good question. I don't really know. We'll have to find out. So everybody, until next time. And we're also going to find out what happened after I played that audio recording of me chewing out that supervisor. Yeah, it's not that great. So, oh shit, are we even really going to be able to talk about that? Because, we can talk about it during the horse race. It's not that big of a deal. Okay, that's true. So, we have $30,000. I guarantee we're not leaving with 30. I'll tell you that right now. So everybody, we'll see you in the next episode. Until then, you all stay classy.